welcome to our journey on the Guitar Weekend to Clarens. We're on our way at the moment. Fifth annual Clarens Guitar Weekend. Pretty much 30 guitar players joining me in the beautiful countryside of Clarens. On a Guitar Weekend, I do lecture them guitar, just a whole bunch of jamming. It's a great, great weekend. Guitar playing is my life. It's what I do. It's what I'm passionate about, and I love hanging with other people that are passionate about guitar playing.
I came here because I'm afflicted with the guitar life,
and it's just wonderful to be in there with 30 other people as passionate as I am about guitar playing.
So this is a way of unashamedly being with a lot of other people who are afflicted by the same condition for a weekend without having to make excuses for it.
All right, workshop one. It's after dinner. We have a bit of a braai. And at about 8:30, we start workshop one. Workshop one is all about improvising and the way I see improvising. And you know, obviously improvising is a massive, massive part of blues rock playing, and it's a massive part of what I do. I'd say 80-90% of what I do every night on stage is improvising, and it can be such a rewarding thing being able to improvise. The way I teach it and the subject matter of it is very, very different to the way institutions teach it and what I believe other teachers teach it. It's a very different way of looking at improvising. It's my way of looking at improvising, and it really seems to work. I see a lot of improvement through the guys on the weekend, and it's probably one of the most vital things we do on the weekend, and it's one of the most vital tools any blues rock guitar player really will ever possess. Yeah, we just finished the first day of my 2012 Guitar Weekend. The first day is always quite an exhausting thing with the setting up of the whole thing, and it's always worth it. The first day is great. The guys get in a bit nervous. You know, they don't know each other and they're a bit shy to play in front of each other. But as you can hear in the background, that problem has been rectified. The guys are playing and jamming and hopefully applying a lot of the stuff we've just done in this workshop. We did our improvising workshop tonight. But I think it was a very successful first day. The stuff that I'm teaching is being put into use in jam sessions. All in all, the first day was very, very successful. Very happy with it. End of day one, it was a great night, and I look forward to tomorrow. Must have been swam back to sacrifice. Workshop 2 is called Licks and Riffs. Weather permitting, we do it on the lawn in front of the stage. This is obviously quite a fun workshop to do. I teach all my favorite licks from the blues masters, B.B. King, Stevie Ray Vaughan, Hendrix, you know, all my favorite players, and all the licks I really benefited from learning from, you know. So I teach all those, explain where they come from, the importance of them, how to put these licks and integrate them into your playing. I do a lot of my own licks. We do licks all the way from fairly basic licks to quite advanced licks, you know. It's always a fun workshop, and the guys take home a lot from this workshop because it's just fun, man. This is really what we as guitar players really live for. I know I've learned a lot from them, and all round absolute great workshop.
We're from Bloem.
I'm from Bloemfontein.
I'm from Uitenhage.
I'm from Bloem.
I'm from Cape Town.
Bloem.
From Bloemfontein.
Centurion.
From Centurion.
Centurion.
I'm from Joburg.
Port Elizabeth.
I'm from Worcester.
Peter Maritzburg.
I've seen Dan play a couple of times, and you can definitely learn from a guy with that kind of experience.
Dan is a player, he's a very, very competent player.
And being a guitar player myself, I've been playing for many years, and actually see what he's doing on the stage and how he actually used the guitar and the sound and the tone. I just had to come here, you know, for the weekend.
Giving me a couple of good ideas as to, you know, where to go to from here. So really glad that I came in.
He's the sex of music, if you want. He puts stuff into it that goes way beyond the theory and the technique.
Well, I've learned so much in the last couple of days.
He kind of, he himself is like afflicted by the guitar life, I think, and that's what comes up.
Between all the workshops, besides all the jamming that goes on between the guys, I do private lessons with the guys. That's part of the weekend package. It's pretty much them really telling me what they want to do in the private lesson. You know, the novice guys are really nervous when they join the weekend, but you know, really they stand to learn the most. Our youngest guy this year is 14 years old, and our oldest guy is, I think, 68 years old, so and everything in between. The one-on-one time with the guys, you get to know the guys, you get to know the guys' strengths and maybe where you can improve on as a player. And it's also cool to get to know the guys attending these weekends. You know, I really want to start doing this with a lot of the young guys too, because I believe developing the youth, you know, with the guitar playing thing, it only breeds culture and guitar culture. And I tell you something, you know, South African can definitely use a lot more love of guitar and love of music. It's just going to make the music industry a lot bigger and a lot better. Right, Russell is a guy I've known for the last 15 years, and Russell is an exceptionally talented guy, you know. With all his challenges he has, I think a lot of people wish they could play guitar like him. He picks up things so quickly. He's an unbelievable player. And he's a real showman too, you know. To find my baby gone. He's a good friend, Russell, but an immensely talented guy. Workshop 3 is all about tone and gear. And, you know, I think most of us guitar players at heart are kind of gearheads and tone junkies. This workshop doesn't involve all the guitar weekenders playing necessarily. It's really more about the gear I use. A lot of guys might be interested in that. And not only about that, about what I think are really good ideas in pedal boards in amps, in guitars, and we really get to the nitty gritty of it. We really get serious into it. We, you know, go from, you know, capacitors to germanium chips in fuzz face boxes, you know, to woods on the guitars. We really, really get into it. And that's more of an open discussion, really, because tone is obviously a very personal thing and no one really has the answer to the perfect tone. So it's more of an open discussion, you know, a really, really interesting workshop and probably my favorite workshop of the entire weekend. As you can see, we're at the end of day two of my annual Clarens Guitar Weekend. Tired, but a very, very exciting day. The Saturday, the day two is always great. It's the only day with two workshops. We started off this morning with breakfast, 8 o'clock this morning, a nice early breakfast, followed by workshop two, which was licks and riffs. Nice here on the lawn, we had great weather today. Well, not great weather, but no rain at least, you know. Did a whole bunch of private lessons today with the guys. We had a great dinner, a great braai this evening, and we did a tone and gear workshop this evening, which is one of my favorite things to talk about is tone and gear, you know. So a great day. I had a great day. I really enjoyed it. I'm sure the guys had a great day too. It was it's always an honor to be doing this, you know. Yeah, so we'll see you tomorrow morning. Babe, rise and shine. I got my pistol right by my side. Wake up, babe, rise and shine. I got my pistol right by my side. Can't find my shooter, boy. It's all a steal. Outside my rolling mill, find myself a deal. Workshop 4 is the final group workshop we do for the weekend, which takes place Sunday morning after breakfast. After a lot of jamming, you know, the guys do a lot of jamming during the days, you know, putting all the stuff that they've learnt in the workshops into sort of practice. So there's a lot of that going on. But workshop 4 is also a very important workshop, which is harmony and chord and rhythm playing. And I think a lot of guitar players, you know, tend to sometimes forget about that because it's not as flashy and as fun as the sort of single line lead guitar playing sort of stuff. But it's such a crucial element. And I think a lot of the guys think, oh, this is going to be a bit of a boring workshop. But the reaction we got from this weekend's workshop for the chords and harmony workshop was great. It really was, because I also teach it in another way. I mean, music theory is music theory, there's no doubt about it, but we seem to put it across in a different way, and the guys really seem to grasp you know, the whole harmony concept and how chords are built and rhythm playing and playing behind the beats and all these very, very important things to being an all-round guitar player, because at the end of the day, you consider yourself a guitar player if you're not a complete all-round guitar player, you know, where you're not nailing everything. So workshop 4, chords and harmony, and also a very, very interesting and fun workshop to do. We end the weekend off sort of with like a finale show for all the guys. It's the farewell night. What they do is they get into groups of three players each, they rehearse a song with my band, and then they perform the song for a local Clarens audience, all the other guitar students, their families, that whole sort of thing. It's always a great thing. Take off your sneakers.
heels, your high heels too. You put your grooving shoes on. Roll up the sleeves on your spandex jackets.
It's unbelievable to see people from all over the country staying in this little small place together and becoming really, really good friends through a very, very common interest. I mean, these guys have been playing for a month, you know, who aren't anywhere near as good as the guys have been playing for the last 15 years. But they're getting up there and they're still doing it and still giving it everything they got. And the whole audience appreciates it. Right at the end of all of this, gift packs get given away by Music Connection and Fender, and there's a whole bunch of goodie bags and all that sort of stuff. But the main prize is a Telecaster to the most improved player by the end of the weekend.
The winner of the prize is Liam.
I'm very thankful to have the great support from people helping us out on this weekend. The Proteo Hotel Group, particularly the Proteo Hotel here in Clarens, where we're sitting right now. A big, big thanks to the Proteo Hotel. Fender Musical Instruments for all their help and input on this weekend, and the great guitar they've given us to give away. And Music Connection, who have given us a lot for this weekend, the goodie bags to give away, you know, part sponsor of the guitar itself. So yeah, very fortunate to have these guys behind us on this weekend helping us out, because it really means a lot and it really does help a lot. Alright, today was the very last day of Guitar Weekend, 2012 Clarens. I had a lot of fun. It was the wettest day of all the days we've had so far, but that definitely didn't damper spirits. We started off this morning with Chords and Harmony Workshop, followed by me completing the private lessons, and then all the guys got together in little groups of three guys per band, and they rehearsed with my band for the performance that has just happened now, and we had a lot of fun, a lot of great playing. And obviously the chair on the top was giving away all the prizes courtesy of Fender and Music Connection. And it was just a great weekend had by all. Thank you to all the guys that have ever attended a weekend before, and especially this weekend, you know. It's always a blast. You always make great friends on this weekend, and yeah, thank you, and we'll see you soon. I ain't got nobody, don't carry me no load.
Got that.